What do I have to research today? Plants? Plants don't grow in space. Biofriend should know something about them. Ah, what are you doing?
Eating an apple?
No, that's so dangerous. What if a seed grows inside your stomach?
Cosmo, that's impossible.
Why are you risking your life? Safety first.
Plants are an important part of a healthy diet. They give us energy and nutrients to help prevent disease, and most importantly, they taste great.
But what about the seeds?
Let me show you. If I eat a seed, it travels into my stomach. My stomach acid breaks down the seed, and what's left enters my intestines, where my body absorbs the seed's nutrients. Anything my body doesn't want gets pooped out. But what if a super seed could grow in my stomach?
This is such a bad idea. Simulation activated. A seed is how a plant reproduces. It's part of the plant's life cycle. A seed has three parts. Inside the seed is the baby plant called an embryo, along with nutrients to feed the embryo. On the outside is a strong seed coat which protects the embryo. When a seed grows into a plant, we call this germination. For a seed to germinate, it needs water, oxygen, and warmth. Human stomachs are too hot and they're full of acid. The seed coat might be strong enough to stop the acid, but the acid would kill the delicate seedling. If a plant is going to grow in your stomach, the super seed and the seedling would need to be acid-proof. Most seeds need 2 to 3 weeks to germinate, but food stays in your stomach for only a few hours before it moves to your intestines and starts becoming poop. If a plant is going to grow in your stomach, it would need super speed and be able to germinate in only a few hours. Most seeds need soil to germinate. The seedling's roots collect water and minerals from the soil. But not all plants grow in soil. Air plants have special leaves that collect water and nutrients directly from the air. Since human stomachs aren't full of dirt, the super seedlings would need to absorb nutrients from whatever was around them. Seedlings grow toward the sun. The young plant collects sunlight and makes sugar through a process called photosynthesis. But it's dark inside your stomach. That means no photosynthesis. But not all plants do photosynthesis. This is an Arnold's Rafflesia plant. It looks like a delicious slice of salami you put on your pizza, but it stinks horribly. Blech! Rafflesia is a parasite. This means it gets its energy by sucking sugar out of other plants. Maybe the super seedling would get its energy by absorbing some food from your stomach. This means you would need to eat enough food to feed yourself and the seedling growing in your stomach.
Cosmo, this was just a simulation. Animals eat seeds all the time.
Like the aardvarks?
Yes, they eat and poop out the seeds. They bury their poop, and this poop helps fertilize the seeds. This is how animals help plants spread their seeds. Feel better, Cosmo?
Yep. Enjoy your apple. Bye, Biofriend. Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. Having a seed grow in your stomach is impossible. What if you conducted an experiment to show why seeds can't grow in your stomach? Step 1, find an adult. Step 2. Gather your supplies. Some seeds, like peas or beans. 4 small pots. Some soil. Some acid, like vinegar. And a marker. Step 3. Using the marker, label the 4 pots. Pot 1, light and water. Pot 2, light and acid. Pot 3, dark and water. Pot 4, dark and acid. Step 4. Fill each pot with soil and add 2 to 3 seeds per pot. Cover the seeds with soil. The plants labeled water are given water to drink. The plants labeled acid are given acid to drink. Step 5. Place the light plants on a windowsill. Place the dark plants in a dark closet. Step 6. Water your plants once a day and observe how they grow over the next 2 weeks. Your stomach is dark and filled with acid. Can a seed survive in your stomach? Happy experimenting, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!